to face with the gift of you. I have heard some folks say that long ago God could not dance to save her soul, but people I've seen her shake that jelly roll just thinking about the gift of you.
Yeah. It's really fun to do as a round.
Eric has lived in a bunch of like intentional communities around the world and does a lot of permaculture projects and stuff like that. And so she didn't come from a kirtan background, but she came from a background of like a lot of medicine songs that she's picked up all over the place that you sing and call and response and stuff like that. Yeah.
But there and I heard the dandy drums. It's called God Dance the Day You Were Born.
I want to hear it. Will you post that on my page?
It's so fun.
Yeah, if you want to play it, I'd love to hear it.
It layers, all three parts layer together in a three-part harmony. Like, if you sing all three verses at the same time, which is how I learned it at the Goddess Gathering.
That's cool!
So where was
it's so fun gathering? To do it. That one was in North Carolina. Yeah. But I think they do them a lot. It's like a network of Goddess Gatherings. They do them in different places over around
that's
the country.
That's cool.
Have you been to Mount Shasta? Or has anyone here been to Mount Shasta?
Isn't that California?
It is in California. Yeah. No, I haven't.
I've never been west of Arizona. Arizona, whichever one's more west, Colorado or Arizona.
I don't know if that.
Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah, I haven't been all the way to the West Coast ever.
You haven't been all the way to the West Coast?
I know! It's so weird. Every time I have a chance to travel, I want to leave the U.S., though. I know there's so much beauty to see. I know there's like a lot of amazing
the West Coast, right? You should see the pictures, my parents, and that.
Yeah.
It's freaking cool.
I've heard. I want to go to New Mexico, too. I'd really like to see Santa Fe.
Santa Fe is beautiful.
And Taos. Yeah. I wanted the ski Taos.
I like the Caribbean. It's some of the places are two different.
Do you want to play it?
Is there any place in the Caribbean you really like?
Trinidad.
You look like 32.
And any wrinkles? Haven't had any gray hair put in yet. No. That's wrong. I saw one come in like 3 years ago, and I plucked it, and I haven't seen any more. So I figured that was like a weird, just random stress thing.
Is that what you were playing? Maybe I'm saying that because I was the one that you
pulled out for.
Are you
50
to
point being in Orlando?
And I was walking up.
You get any wanderer feelings?
Well, my plan was to move to India by August of 2014. I got accepted to the Chinmaya Mission 2-year Vedanta course that is the same course that all of their swamis go through. Yeah, and you don't have to necessarily take sannyas and become a swami, but it is called the Brahmacharya course, and a lot of people choose to take vows of Brahmacharya and wear all white and serve the mission in different locations around the world. Some people go back to their life. You know, Swami Chinmayananda doesn't necessarily have to be your guru, which is good.
Right.
But a lot of, probably at least 50% of the graduates take sannyas.
Forest is over.
And about 1,500 applications come in, and they do it every 3 years, and then they accept around 45 people. And I got accepted. So I thought, well, you know, then apparently it's meant to be that I go to the course. If you live in India, though, it's free. If you're coming from outside of India, it's about $6,000, depending on whether you want AC. It's like between $5,000 and $6,000 for the whole 2 years, including room, board, books, everything. But which is a bet, like, you know what I mean? But I got accepted like to the course in April, and you had to be in August, and I spent the whole year unemployed. So I did a crowdfunding campaign, did nothing.
Before that, I just felt like and cold. And then after that, I felt
August
like
came and went. I kind of abandoned my whole career path because my whole mind was like, I'm leaving, so I'm not going to form any more attachments to anything.
Oh, I know. That's what I'm saying before.
After that didn't work out, I was like, I don't know what to do with my life now. I don't really want anything to do with the whole workaday world. So I wrote my guru. I'm like, Mom, can I just come live at your ashram? And she's like, no, work in the world, do your karma yoga. You know, your time will come, but it's not now. And I'm like, no. So like ever since then, it's just been like, if I have to be here and pay bills, I at least want to engage in things I like to do. So the kirtan thing just sort of arose naturally out of that, because it was like, well, what am I going to do that while I'm here that's a contribution that's meaningful to me and that matters? Yeah, so then I started recording the album, and
that's still in process.
Yeah, but the producer and I, who was a really good friend of mine, he just disappeared from my life, really, for no apparent reason. So he dropped out of the project at the same time, and he took all the files for the album with him. So I've had to, I've had to start from scratch, and I've been having to find a studio, so that's why it's been so delayed.
I didn't test it.
Yes.
What was the purpose of that? What did you think he was going to do with these?
I had never heard from him. I came home to the apartment one day. Like, he was living here.
I
came home and all his stuff was gone, and there was like no, nothing.
No, you guys, this is it. Oh, I bet you they're going to sing it in three parts so that you can hear it.
Yay!
Here, so you can listen to it.
Can you guys hear it?
Yeah.